Hey there, I'm Hossein, and in this series, we're going to dive into like 10 super useful Rhino commands, right? Step by step and totally hands-on. So like, let's jump right into the first part. All right, so let's talk about this offset command, yeah? It's like super handy for creating a parallel version of a curve at a specified distance. I mean, seriously, it's really useful for making borders, CNC paths, or just spacing between lines, you know? So here's how you do it. First, you execute the command, right? You type in per offset. Then you select the curve you want, and you enter the distance. After that, just use your mouse to indicate which direction the offset should be created. Oh, and don't forget to confirm, okay? And here are some simple tips. With both sides, you can create an offset on both sides, which is pretty neat. And with sharp la round, you can decide if the corners should be sharp or rounded. It's really that simple and quick. If you need thickness or spacing, offset curve is like one of the first tools you'll be reaching for, trust me. All right, so check this out. The match surface command is super handy, right? It's like when you want to get two surfaces to, you know, align perfectly or feel smooth together. So picture this. If two surfaces aren't sticking together just right or their connection looks all messy, that's when you whip out the match surface tool. You can totally line up those edges and make everything nice and sleek. It's especially useful when you're working on freeform models or organic shapes. Now, let's break it down step by step. Here we go. One, first, you got to run the command match surface. Two, then select an untrimmed surface edge, okay? Three, next, pick a surface edge or curve that you want to match. Just make sure you're choosing the two surfaces near the same ends. Easy peasy. This can be either trimmed or untrimmed, no worries there. Four, finally, choose your options and boom, you've got those surfaces looking good together. When we talk about options, we've got a few simple points to consider. First up, position. This one just aligns the edges, you know, just keeps them in place. Then there's tangency, which, oh man, it's like magic. It aligns the new surface with the reference surface to make everything feel super smooth, right? And then, oh, we've got curvature. This is the softest and most professional way to connect things. Now, if you ever find that when you're shaping surfaces, they just don't clean up nicely, or if the connections look all stepped and awkward, you gotta try match surface. Rebuild, right? This tool, it's super handy when you wanna like clean up a complex curve or surface, make it lighter or just more manageable. So what it does is it changes the number of control points and the degree of that curve or surface to make the geometry tidier and way easier to edit. It's especially useful when you're doing form making and working with those soft surfaces. Okay, so here are the steps you got to follow. One, first, run the command rebuild. Two, then you select your curve or surface, right? Three, next, you specify the new number of control points and the degree. Four, after that, you get to see a preview of the result. Five, finally, you just hit confirm. Okay, so like, let's talk about rebuilding, right? So the fewer control points you have, the simpler and cleaner your geometry is gonna be, you know? And if you go for a higher degree, like say three or even five, you're gonna end up with a much smoother surface, which is pretty awesome, right? And don't forget about that preview option. It's super helpful to see how much your shape is changing. Clipping plan. And it's super handy because it lets you cut away a part of your model temporarily. You know, like you get to see inside it without actually chopping up the geometry. It's kind of like having a live section that's just for display. Seriously, if you want to check out spaces, control the internal volume, or present some architecture, this tool is just perfect. So here's what you got to do, okay? One. First, you run the command clipping plan. Two, then just double click to define your cutting plane. Three, anything that gets sliced by this plane, boom, it disappears from view and you can see inside it. How wild is that? Four, oh, And if you want to switch things up, just select clipping plane and you can flip the direction of the cut. 5. And when you're done, just select it and hide or delete it. Easy peasy. All right, so let's break this down a bit about clipping planes, yeah? So first off, it doesn't actually change the real geometry, right? It just controls how it gets displayed. Pretty neat, huh? And guess what? You can have multiple clipping planes. Like, how awesome is that? Oh, and it's super useful for rendering engines like V-Ray or Enscapes too, which is a total bonus. When you shift that plane around, it's like the cut section moves live. So if you ever need to quickly check the inside of a form or grab a momentary section cut, clipping planes are seriously one of the best tools you can use. Isn't that just fascinating? The next command is bend. With the bend command, you can totally curve something like a curve surface or even a solid around an axis. It's super useful for creating those organic forms, bending profiles, or reshaping volumes without having to model everything all over again. All right, so here's how you do it, step by step. 1, execute the command bend. 2, select the object you want, like the one that's just sitting there waiting for some action. 3, define the bending baseline with 2 points, easy peasy. 4, use your mouse to set how much you want to bend it. Seriously, just play around with it. 5, and then like confirm it, boom. You're all set to create something amazing. All right, so let's talk about this bend thing, yeah? So like the further you are from the baseline, right, the more it bends. Crazy, right? And get this, you can actually input a number for how much you want it to bend. Like seriously, it's super handy for those organic edits and formal stuff too, you know? If you're looking to bend something without all the hassle, bend is like one of the best options out there. Isn't that wild? Hey, so if you haven't subscribed to the channel yet, could you please do that? It would be super awesome. And don't forget to hit the bell icon so you can get all the updates on our new videos, right? Also, if you like what you see, giving a thumbs up and sharing the video really helps us out. And, you know, if you have any thoughts or suggestions about the tutorials we're doing, we'd totally love to hear from you in the comments. That's like super important to us. All right, so like, let's talk about the dimensions command. Yeah, this thing is all about measuring in your model, right? You can totally show distances, heights, angles, and diameters right on your map. It's super important for presentations, documentation, or like preparing workshop drawings, you know? So here's how you do it. 1, just pick one of the commands. I'm going with dim linear, right? 2, choose 2 points or objects, easy peasy. 3, then you just decide where you want to display the numbers. Cool. 4, and then just hit confirm, like boom. All right, so like let's dive into dimensions, yeah? So there are like different types, right? You've got linear, aligned, radius, diameter, and oh, angle. It's pretty wild. And get this, you can totally change the style of the dimensions, like the font, color, and size. How neat is that? And the best part, it's editable and always shows the actual value of the model. Super essential for presenting maps and details, for sure. If you want your model to be readable and functional, dimensions are like one of the most basic tools you really need. Okay, so like, let me tell you about named views, right? You can totally save your favorite views of the model, and whenever you want, you just zip right back to them. It's super handy, especially when you've got a big or complex model and you need to switch between views quickly or prepare for a presentation. So here's the deal. 1, just run the command fair named view. 2, save the current view with a name that you choose. Cool. 3, and whenever you feel like it, Just pick that name and boom, you're right back to that view. You can totally create different names for your views, like your presentation views, plans, and details. It's super handy, you know? And for rendering or presenting, it's like really quick and practical. Plus, those saved views, they get stored with your Rhino file, which means you can move them between projects. How awesome is that? Seriously, using named views makes managing your views and presenting your model way easier. Isn't that just neat? Okay, so like there's this command, right? It's called SelOpenCrv. And like what it does is super cool. It automatically selects all the open curves in your scene. I mean, how handy is that? Especially when you want to do like specific operations on those open curves, like move, trim, or offset. So here's how it goes. Step by step. One, you just run the command, say, select open curve. Two, all the open curves are selected. Three, and then like you can just perform whatever operation you want on them. Isn't that just amazing? Create UV curve and apply UV curve. Super handy for working with curves on surfaces. Okay, so create UV curve. That one, it actually creates a curve from the UV coordinates of the surface. And then there's apply UV curve, which applies that curve you just made onto the surface you want. It's really awesome for designing paths, guiding lines, or transferring curves onto those complex surfaces. So, like, here's how you do it in just a few simple steps. One, first you've got to select the surface you want, right? Two, then just execute the create UV curve or apply UV curve command. Three, after that, you specify the direction or path of the curve on the surface. Four, finally, check the result and give it the thumbs up. Easy peasy, right? Okay, so like here are some simple tips, right? First off, they're super useful for those guide curves or like tiny lines on organic surfaces. You know what I mean? And with this method, you can totally place those curves just perfectly on like all those complex curvy forms. It's really neat. Usually you'd want to pair it up with UV mapping too, so everything turns out like super precise and totally manageable. The next command is purge, right? And this little gem is all about cleaning up those extra useless items in your Rhino file. You know, like those empty layers, unused blocks, materials, and those sneaky hidden errors. Seriously, it's a game changer for keeping your file tidy and speeding up your workflow. So, how do you do it? One, you just run the command car purge. Two, pick the items you want to get rid of, or like just go for the whole shebang at once. Three, then confirm it and boom, all those unused items are gone. All right, so here's the thing, right? Simple tips, you know? First off, the file, it gets lighter and faster, which is like super important. And before you hit that purge button, make sure you double check that the necessary items don't get wiped out. I mean, especially in big projects where you've got tons of blocks and layers, this is like super practical, you feel me? With purge, your file stays clean and organized, making it way easier to manage. All right, so in this section, we just went over 10 super simple, but totally awesome Rhino commands, right? Like, these can seriously make your daily modeling tasks way easier and faster. These commands are the foundation, and if you really nail them, every project you work on is going to flow so much smoother, and your models, they'll look even better. So we're definitely going to have more videos like this, and in each one, I'll try to break down practical tips and tricks in a way that's super easy to follow, you know? Also, I've got this special playlist just for beginners on Rhino in the channel, and I dropped the link in the description, so you've got to check it out. Make sure to watch the previous videos too, because it's going to help you build a really strong foundation in modeling. Okay, so if this video was helpful for you, like, could you please hit that like button? And oh, don't forget to subscribe and turn on the notification bell, right? So you won't miss any new videos. Also, I'd totally love it if you dropped a comment below and let me know what you'd like the next episode to be about, like what technique or recipe you're curious about. So I'm Hossein. Until next time, good luck and keep your models super clean and precise.